24 hours after her release from prison, pardoned mother Kathleen Folbigg has given us an insight into her new life. After two decades behind bars, the convicted baby killer is relishing in the simple things while grappling with how much the world has changed.
Hello, it's Kathleen.
Finally free to tell her own story about the pain of losing four children.
For the last 20 years I have been in prison. I have forever and will always think of my children, grieve for my children, and have missed them and loved them terribly.
Day one of Kathleen Folbigg's new life involved smelling the roses and reconnecting with everything she's missed.
I'm extremely humbled and extremely grateful for being pardoned and released from prison.
In a PR-produced video, the 55-year-old was triumphant.
Today is a victory for science and especially truth.
Thanking the loyal supporters who helped secure her release.
My eternal gratitude goes to my friends and family, especially Tracy and all of her family, and I would not have survived this whole ordeal without them.
It was Tracy Chapman who rolled out the welcome mat. The convicted baby killer pardoned yesterday after a scientific discovery created reasonable doubt over her guilt. Within 40 minutes, Folbigg had swapped her small jail cell for a sprawling North Coast oasis, security manning the perimeter as she partied like it was 2003.
We've had a bit of a flashback to 20 years. She asked for a Kahlua and Coke.
Two schoolmates spending the night playing catch-up.
The phones have bamboozled her a bit this morning. Yeah, and yesterday. She was just a bit like, you know, how do I use this? So she hasn't actually tried. Even the television, she was going, oh my God, look at the television. It's got so many capabilities.
Folbigg's legal team says it's too early to talk compensation, but clearly that is the end game here. The Court of Criminal Appeal can wipe her record clean, and they're trying to get there from every angle.
If Mr. Bathurst does not refer it, we will be asking the governor to refer it because she has that power. Failing that, we will be making an application to the Court of Criminal Appeal.
An exoneration would force the government to pull out the chequebook.
Well, look, you can't put a price on it, obviously.
There are a few who have walked the same path as Kathleen Folbigg. Roseanne Beckett was wrongly jailed for a decade, framed for plotting to kill her husband in 1991.
They just think you're a terrible person, you've done these terrible things. When you haven't, and you know you haven't, but you've got to suffer that.
She was awarded more than $4 million.
So cruel. No amount of money would compensate her for what she's lost.
From one wronged woman to another, some advice on how to survive this next chapter.
People come out of the woodwork, to be honest. Just stay with the people you know, trust the people you know, and you'll be pulled from pillar to post. Just keep standing, girl.
Tiffany Genders, 9 News.